In this video, I'm going to show you how to paint a picture frame quickly and easily. In fact, painting a picture frame is easy, if you know how. Hi, I'm Jessica, artist with twowaymirrors.com. Every day, we frame one-of-a-kind mirrors for celebrities and DIY enthusiasts. I'm going to give you my top techniques on the type of frames to use, the best paint and brushes, and any other tools that you'll need. Painting frames creates a unique style that's impossible to find in standard frame molding. Applications for painted frames include smart mirrors, framing art for historical periods, antiquing frames for historic rooms, distressed frames for haunted houses, and bright, playful colors for kids' rooms. I've left you all the details below on advanced frame paintings such as archival framing and water gilding. Now, I'll take you through some simple techniques on how to transform ordinary picture frames into stunning works of art. Let's get started. First, choose the type of frame that you'll be working with. Pre-made frames can be purchased inexpensively in standard sizes from your local big box store. If you're purchasing frame material, decide if you want to decorate molding, unfinished molding, crown molding, or shadow box frame molding. You'll also want to consider if you'd prefer real wood, which costs more than plastic, or MDF. You'll also want to consider the color that you'll want as the background, typically white, black, or wood tones. If you're making your own frame, cut the frame using a chop saw and join the wood pieces together using wood glue and straps or angle braces. I'll leave you the step-by-step instructions down below. Check out the details below if you'd like to put a display behind your frames and turn them into digital art. The type of paint that you choose will depend on the material that your frame is made from, as well as your personal preference. Chalk paint works best on wood frames, and the acrylic multi-surface paint is great for wood and plastic frames. Spray paint typically works well with any material and is often the type of paint that's chosen. The reason for this is because the spray paint creates an even finish and also is inexpensive and fast. When possible, the contents of the frame should be removed before beginning the painting process. However, if that isn't a viable option for you, you can use masking tape and newspaper to cover the glazing and contents of your frame. This will add protection in that area. Before applying paint to any of your frames, be sure to wipe the frames down with a damp cloth to remove any dust or debris that may have accumulated on the surface. Once the frames are dry, place them on a tarp in a well-ventilated area, since paint fumes are harmful to your lungs. Before applying the paint, we recommend testing the paint that you chose on a piece of paper or cardboard to ensure that it's a color that you like. Applying a high-quality primer before any paint is strongly recommended. This is because the priming base will help your paint adhere to the frame surface and help you avoid paint chipping. When using spray paint, shake the can for about 3 minutes and perform a test spray so that you'll be sure to achieve an even paint job. Apply the spray paint about 6 to 8 inches from the surface while doing a sweeping motion. You will most likely need more than one coat, but oil-based spray paints dry to the touch within about 30 minutes. So apply as many coats as you feel necessary every 30 minutes. Let the spray-painted frame dry overnight before hanging your new masterpiece on your wall. Are you interested in learning more cool home DIY techniques? If so, hit that subscribe button right now so you don't miss them. If spray painting just isn't your style, that's okay. Chalk paint works wonders on wooden frames, and the process is almost exactly the same as spray painting. Instead of spraying the frame, we recommend that you use a Dixie Belle bell brush along with chalk paint on wooden frames. Chalk paint will allow you to achieve that beautiful matte finish and typically is able to paint over any other paint and doesn't need to be placed over a priming coat. However, chances are you will still most likely need another coat. Allowing the first coat to dry fully before applying any more coats, and again, allowing the frame to dry overnight before hanging your masterpiece on your wall. When painting a plastic frame, acrylic multi-surface paint is the way to go. The process is basically the same as the spray painting process. We recommend using the Princeton brand brushes when applying acrylic multi-surface paint to your frames. They are great for acrylic paints and have a wide variety of different sizes to choose from. With this style, we do recommend applying a high-quality primer to your frame before applying acrylic paint. Use sweeping motions with your brush to apply an even coat, and when needing more than one coat, allow the paint to dry fully before applying the next coat. Let the frames dry overnight before displaying your eye-catching work of art. If you're looking to create a galaxy or abstract one-of-a-kind frame, check out the acrylic pouring style of painting. When setting up to do an acrylic pour, make sure you have a newspaper or a small tarp under where you plan to paint. You will want to begin by spraying the frame with a paint primer. After you've primed your frame, simply mix your desired colors of acrylic paints together in a cup. Then pour the cup of mixed paints onto the frame surface. To spread the paint evenly across your frame, gently tilt it in different directions, and this will disperse the paint around the entire surface. You'll want to allow the frame ample time to dry before hanging it up, since the paint could potentially be thicker than a different style of painting would be. If you want to add texture to your frames, using a painting sponge and dabbing it onto your frames will create a unique and mesmerizing textured appearance. You can also use hot glue guns to add extra personalized details onto your frame, such as burlap and felt flowers. The possibilities are endless. Well, that's all for this video. Leave a comment down below on what techniques that you plan to use to customize your frames. Until next time, I'm Jessica with Two Way Mirrors, and I'll see you in my next video.